when I voted with the Republicans, I got texts and calls that you're against the children.
Right.
And you're against
That's always a debate.
Right. And the problem is this, is as I debated it and looked up in the gallery, I saw the advocates for kids with special needs. I saw the advocates for autistic kids. I saw the advocates for foster kids. And if we get in a recession and we have to tighten the screws like we have before, and we've mandated the GCEI, which is which would be $150 million, which they tried to do to Hogan, then we're going to have to cut somewhere. And when we cut...
No, they won't. That's what they do. They raise the alcohol tax. Like they did last time. And they promised that money to the special needs kids. And what did they do, Senator Brochin? They took that money and gave it to Baltimore City Education and Prince George's County.
That's exactly what they did. And not only that, they're going to have to cut, you know, they're going to have to cut Medicaid also. So when they do these, you're going to be hurting kids. You're just going to be hurting a different pot of kids. And the most important thing, and I hope the takeaway that all your listeners get, is that when Martin O'Malley took office... the facts are the facts. You can't hide from them. Bob Ehrlich left him with close to $1 billion surplus. Okay, Larry Hogan takes office. Okay, Martin O'Malley left him with a $750 million debt. And not only did he leave him with a $750 million structural debt, but the way that O'Malley closed a quarter of that debt was by cutting Medicaid. Where were the advocates when O'Malley cut Medicaid?
And it's important to add on top of that, people talk about the 2% pay raise for state employees, that 2% was added on right at the end of O'Malley's term. He didn't, you know, did that through executive order, did that type of thing, as opposed to, as Governor Hogan had said, please don't do anything before I take over. Let me review this and look at this. So I think it's important that 2% that's put in there, that came in at the very end of O'Malley's service.
Yeah, and I gotta tell you something, I'm not switching parties, and I'm still happy I'm a Democrat, but I'm not sticking around for this duplicity, and I'm not keeping my mouth shut for this hypocrisy.
Don't turn your mic off.
Because it's disgusting. It absolutely made me sick. All of a sudden, the GCI has to be funded 100% because Larry Hogan's the governor. Okay, the double standard is so striking and so unfair that I don't care if I speak about it for the next 4 years until I'm blue in the face. But there is no way that they can pull this off and make this sound like reality, because it's not.
Let's get Cindy.